As we take a look at the lanes, United States, the big favorites in lane four. Anyway, anybody else here is going to challenge them.
No way. No matter how you break it down, the U.S. should not and will not lose this relay. Only way they lose is if they disqualify themselves by jumping early. A relay exchange is the only way they're going to lose this one. There'll be teams close maybe the first two legs, but after that, it's all over.
You see Brendan Hansen there fired up. He's looking for his first Olympic gold medal after coming up short in both of his breaststroke events earlier. Silver in the 100, bronze in the 200.
Well, that's his teammate, not only for the United States. This is sort of a hook 'em horn relay, too. You've got three Texas guys in there. Pearsall, Brendan Hansen, and Crocker all swam for the University of Texas. So this is going to be one special relay. And watch for the world record. It could go on the first leg. Natalie Coughlin almost did it in their medley relay.
So off goes Aaron Pearsall in the Americans' pursuit of gold. Pearsall looking for triple gold at these Olympics after sweeping the two backstroke events.
Well, he'll be out quickly from a right here. This is where Aaron Pearsall likes to build into the wall. He'll have a great turn here. There's some other good, solid backstrokers that made this 100 backstroke very close in the individual 100, but I don't think anybody can hang with Aaron Pearsall the last 10 or 15 meters. That's how he won his 100 earlier this week.
Always have to be careful with the exchanges between the swimmers. Inevitably, it seems like in every event, there's at least one team that has a disqualification, so it's something you have to keep on your mind, even though you're the heavy favorite. As Pearsall goes into the wall here, Brendan Hansen is in next for the U.S.
Watch for the world record! He did it! He broke the world record leading off the relay!
So I guess things are off to a good start.
You might say that for the United States, a world record on the first leg. Talk about special. Oh, my goodness, clear sailing from here. Now, you'll see some teams get back into it. But, oh, boy, what a great leg for Aaron Pearsall to kick this baby off.
And that takes Lenny Kraselberg's world record off the books for the United States. But there is Brendan Hansen turning after the lead Pearsall gave him.
Well, you see Kitajima right there. He won the 100 breaststroke earlier. He'll start to move up a little bit. But believe me, I don't think Brendan Hansen's going to give him any room.
Hansen has seen enough of Kitajima at these Olympics, hasn't he? It was Kitajima who beat him out in both the 100 and the 200, sweeping the gold medals in that. So Hansen goes to the wall. Japan is about a half body length away.
And here he is, Ian Crocker. He now gets to swim for gold.
Crocker, who had the two disappointing swims to begin these Olympics, didn't make it out of the prelims of the 100 free, and then in that 400 free relay, swam a very, very slow split.
It was very disappointing. You know, when Ian got the word, he was very emotional about it. When Michael Phelps said, "You're the guy," the idea that a guy that you race against over and over, and all of a sudden you beat him and get a chance to swim the medley relay in the finals, he says, "No, Ian Crocker, it's yours. You're going to bring it home." He's a great relay swimmer, not only the world record holder.
Yeah, kind of ironic that Crocker, whose picture's been up on Phelps's wall, gets this nice gift from Phelps. Crocker's work is over, and into the pool goes Jason Lezak with a world record on his mind.
Well, he's over a half a second ahead of the world record right now, and he's got nice, clean water. You see how smooth that water is? Now, Lezak also had a disappointing swim in the 100 free, but there's no way he's going to do it here. He came back big time in the 50 by getting in there and getting the finals. He'll bring it home for the United States. The key is, will he break the world record?
Lezak finished fifth in that 50 free, didn't make it out of the prelims of the 100, so a disappointing Olympics for him so far. There is the world record line, and you can see how far ahead Lezak is ahead of it. It's catching up to him a little bit here.
It's not going to catch him. He's going to break it. He's going to break it.
He's dying.
He's
a little
get
bit
it.
Here at the end. It's going to be close. It is a new world record, just barely. Germany takes the silver. Japan gets the bronze. The team guy that he is, cheering on from the stands tonight as Ian Crocker swims his leg for him. The United States, the gold medal in world record fashion.